Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a comparison video for you all on the Real Techniques Complexion Sponge and the Beauty Blender. Now, I've seen quite a few comparison dupe videos on this, and I must say the ones that I've watched in regards to this have been false. And I never intended on doing this video, but I did think that because I've seen so many opinions that I completely disagree on, I should put a video out there. So that's what I'm doing right now. So this is my Real Techniques Complexion Sponge. I've had it for about maybe 6 weeks to 2 months, and I've been using it almost every day, just testing it out. And then if I haven't been using this, I've been using my my Beauty Blender. Now, I've just washed both of these with baby soap, baby shampoo. You can see that the Real Techniques one has a lot of staining on it. If you can see that at all, like you can see in this area, like this is kind of dark and like foundation color, and that's like orange. While this one is basically clean, besides like that little bit that I was too lazy to get out. Like when I wringed it out, it kind of just stayed. But besides that, like, where foundation comes in contact with this, it stains. This one will wash out. Straight off the bat, you can tell that the Beauty Blender is well made, or better made rather, than this one, because seriously, it's no effort at all. All I did was squeeze the soap through it a few times and just wringed it out and washed it with water, and it came to this basically. While this one, I've done the exact same thing and this is what happens. It's still very, very stained. Now, that's not to say that when I put them on my face, I don't get the same result. I do. So I put my foundation on this side with the Beauty Blender, this side with the Real Techniques Complexion Sponge. You can't tell the difference. I can't tell the difference. You get the same end result. But this is definitely a lot more fluffy than this. This, when you get to the middle, it's really, really dense. And I don't know, it's not as fluffy. It's definitely a little bit more dense than this one, which is a lot more airy. I don't really like the shape of this one. Like, it's nice for getting underneath the eyes, but I don't really like it for the actual face. I do prefer the Beauty Blender just because I can point it and actually use it where I need it. While this one, it's kind of like hard to get like up into like the corners and like bits of my face. While this one, it's super, super easy. So that's that. I do prefer the shape of the Beauty Blender. Like, straight off the bat, I do prefer the Beauty Blender, not because of the price, because I bought mine on sale for $17, while this I bought for like $8 or something like that from iHerb. You can now get this in Priceline in Australia if you're wondering. And so far, I don't really know anywhere in store where you can buy the Beauty Blender besides iMats.
I'm getting out of breath.
So application, it's like, it's the same, you get the same result. But it's definitely a texture thing. They're nowhere near as fluffy. Like, this one is so fluffy and so airy. This one is so hard and dense and compact. But yeah, so overall, I do like both of these, but they're no way dupes of each other. This is a lot more compact. It does stain. This one, it's a lot more airy and it doesn't stain. But overall, they're both not bad products. I just don't think they're dupes. This one is definitely a lot more harder on the face when you're tapping it into your skin. This one is a lot more bouncy. I hope that made sense. You can use these for a lot of things. So I use them for foundation, concealer, liquid highlighter, bronzer, liquid bronzer that is. Just a whole lot of things. Even just fading in my eyebrows, I will just sometimes dab my sponge over it and it will kind of just fade it in to be more natural. So yeah. Overall, I like them, but they're not dupes of each other. Do not get mistaken that because they're both complexion sponges, that they're dupes. That's something that I hate about the YouTube community. Once something thinks it's like it, everyone assumes that it's a dupe. It's not a dupe, but it is very, very similar. This one, I must admit, is a little less well made, purely for the fact that I can see it stain, and this one I've had for like a year and it still hasn't really stained at all. So yeah, that's my final thoughts. I don't think they're bad, either of them, but I do prefer the Beauty Blender. That's not to say that I won't continue to use this. I definitely will, but I do like the Beauty Blender better. So yeah, I hope that helped. It was a little bit all over the place, but yeah, I hope you're having a wonderful day. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.